Hello, and welcome to the official documentation of the Mesh Deformation Package version 15, 2021. In this documentation, I will go through all the latest features that I've been working on, and I will try to explain most of the practical stuff that should every user know. I will go straight to the point, as I made many documentation videos in the past, and many things have been explained in the previous documentations. And they're still related. The version 15 brings many new features, including major refactor and package upgrade with various utilities for further use. However, there are not big differences between older versions. It's still pretty the same, but features, performance and package quality has rapidly increased, thanks to the community and many projects that use the package. Thanks to you, the package has become verified and tested by many users worldwide. Okay, now let's get to the package. I've got a funny demo project here called Blabibo that has been made clearly with all the tools provided by the Mesh Deformation package. As you could read from the documentation, the package is divided into 5 categories: essentials, modifiers, shaders, shapes, and utilities. You can read more about each category in the official documentation. Let's say I would like to modify this low poly rock object. Let's add a mesh pro editor. Create a new mesh reference. Now my mesh is ready to be modified. I would like to move some vertices, so let's click the vertices category. The vertices will show up and I can easily edit the mesh. I can also enable the animation mode, which will help me to keep the generated points during the playtime. It's recommended to keep it enabled when you are going to animate the vertices. You can also use zone generator, which will generate a vertices in the specific radius. All the other options are explained in the previous documentations. Let's jump into mesh modification, which contains internal and external modifiers. I would like to smooth the rock, so first I will subdivide the mesh, which means I will increase the vertex count, and then I will click on the mesh smooth. The rock is now ready for further modification. Let's use some external modifiers. I would like to use the new FFD modifier. The freeform deform modifier is great stuff to quickly edit your mesh by the generated lattice. Let's say the lattice would be 3x3x3 and click refresh. I can also customize grid, threshold, density, bias, multiplier and more. I could also use the FFD on the other objects, such as this island. If you press register weights manually, the vertices will refresh their positions to the edited positions and you can continue in editing. There is another great modifier called Mesh Effector, which affects the mesh by radial distance. I'm going to use one-pointed effector type and let's see what happens. You can use any object that will represent the required weight node in the Mesh Effector modifier. Click Refresh Effector Weights and edit your mesh. These two modifiers allow you to edit meshes very quickly in an effective way, so I use them a lot while editing huge levels. Version 15 brings many major upgrades related to the simulations. Let's make some basic simulation with upgraded world interactive modifiers. I'll create a new plane, create a new reference of it, subdivide vertices, apply noise on it to make it more bumpy, and let's add a mesh line modifier. Mesh slime is a very similar modifier to the interactive surface, but the mesh slime is more focused on slime-like surface. So I would like to have a surface that will behave, well, obviously, like a slime. Let's enable the ripper feature, set the ripper speed and other parameters. As you can see, I can interact with the slime while pressing the cursor. There's plenty of potential behind this modifier. You can also create pretty satisfying effects. Now let's create some procedural meshes. The package contains plenty of new advanced and procedural meshes. You can even use the hexagon grid to create hexagonal shapes. As you can see, you can clearly edit any path with user-friendly node editor. And there is even more of it. And you can also do the same with the tunnel creator, which has an advanced editor with further features. There are plenty of other modifiers that can be used in any case, but I think they are pretty understandable and I explained all of them in the previous documentations. There is a huge change in version 15 and that's the connection between all the modifiers. All the modifiers and essential components check the mesh identity before the single initialization. There is a very important window called Mesh Deformation Preferences, which allows you to edit window pop-ups related to the package, maximum allowed number of the vertex count, and so on. Basically, it's a global controller for the package. If you're annoyed of the editor windows popping out while using the modifiers, or you would like to change the maximum vertex count limit, you can change these settings and many others in the Preferences window. Now let's switch to the VR. The package version 15 had a major upgrade related to the VR. Now you can use all VR platforms, including Oculus Quest, to edit meshes in VR at real time. Let's use the built-in Unity XR platform. All the other platforms has a very same setup process, so you don't have to worry if you will go with Steam VR or Oculus integration. There are just another inputs and several third party requirements. Unity XR requires just an XR core, which you can install via Package Manager. I'm going to import the XR package and create a new blank scene with simple VR player. Now, I will add a Mesh Editor Runtime VR component to both hands. As you can see, the component requires a proper VR input behavior which will control specific buttons on my VR controllers. So let's add an MD input VR in my platform, which is XR. Choose a button that you would like to use to grab a vertices, and there you go. At the end, we need some objects to edit. Let's create a simple cube. Add a mesh per editor component and enable animation mode to keep the vertices during the runtime. And as you can see, my VR is working. You can also do the mesh painting and sculpting. You can do all the exact things as on your PC. There are many example scenes that will help you in all possible ways. Okay, that was my quick introduction to the Mesh Deformation Package version 15, and I hope it was useful for you. If you have any questions, issue reports or suggestions, do not hesitate and contact me on my official Discord channel or reach me out on my email. Good luck!